here they come, zipping into Canadian cities one by one and into this privately owned district of Toronto for the first time today.
It's like being on a bike, but you know, just it's better. It's like you channel your inner little kid.
Electric scooters aren't allowed on public streets in Ontario yet, but with regulations under review, they could soon be invading this city.
They're using an environmentally friendly solution to get around. They're solving a congestion issue. Like, there's a lot of huge benefits for a city that creates that so-called mess.
Yes, they have made a mess in other cities where e-scooters were dumped willy-nilly, even in a wading pool in Edmonton. When they came to Montreal last month, the city was ready.
It hasn't really turned out to be the scooter apocalypse we imagined, mainly because the city's done a good job of restricting the number of scooters that have shown up in the city of Montreal.
While Montreal gave e-scooters designated parking spots, that didn't fully solve the dumping problem. And there's more trouble, too.
E-scooters are usually unlocked using an app. Users have to accept a long agreement that says they'll wear a helmet and take other safety precautions. But in other cities, those safety steps have been ignored all too often.
Take Calgary, where e-scooters were introduced in July. This doctor says since then, riders have made nearly 350 emergency room visits. And he's one of the few who wears a helmet.
You're in a vertical position, and especially if you are using the scooter in the non-recommended area. So for example, on a street with vehicular traffic, that's really quite a risky proposition.
Problem is, either riders don't stick to the rules or regulators can't keep up. So Ontario's pilot project will run for a whole 5 years. Thomas Dagg, CBC News, Toronto.